The dairy herd, still a major source of income on many American farms. As production costs continue to rise, a growing number of dairymen are switching from sales of raw milk to retailing a variety of dairy products. For example, the Henry Grafstra family of Arlington, Washington, sells fluid milk, ice cream, and other dairy products, as well as a wide variety of foods, through their own dairy store and selected grocery outlets. Every year, some 20,000 regular customers buy the Grafstra Country Charm dairy products, which are produced right on the family farm.
Well, since we've started this retail outlet, we've been at it, it'll be 5 years in September. We sell it direct. We don't go through any jobbers or anything like this. We have developed the market in 3 years as people have sized it. Investment-wise, we have probably doubled the investment. We started, and we probably increased the value of our raw product by probably 66%. And I think there's one thing that you have to have. When you sell your own milk, you've got to have real high-quality raw milk. Because you can run through this processing equipment, but it doesn't make it any better. It has to be good to start with, and I think this is the first criteria that you must have.
Fresh, quality products attract many customers, and everyone in the Grafstra family takes an active part in the production and retailing of their Country Charm dairy products. That's true, too, at the dairy farm and store near Redmond, Washington.
At the present time, we're milking approximately 120 cows this day, and we have plans with increasing the size of the herd, and the area around here is growing so fast that we have to increase our herd to keep up with the...
We have a nice dairy store. People come every week to buy the milk. Families buy about 2.5 gallons of milk a week. And it's a family operation.
We could be in dairy business in this location if it wasn't for our retail store, because of the increase in taxes and the value of the land, it just wouldn't be feasible for us to stay in.
But selling better known dairy products isn't the only way for them to increase profit without expanding the size of dairy herds. Joe and Aitken and four other Minnesota dairy families are making and selling farm-fed cheese, a process developed by University of Minnesota faculty members.
European cheesemakers have been making farm for many hundreds of years. We have adopted their methods and improved on them using modern technology. One of the recent developments that we've used in our program is the use of a frozen concentrated starter culture. This frozen concentrate eliminates the need of the farm cheesemaker to carry a starter culture on the farm.